Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to be flying from Shenandoah Valley, Virginia to Shepherd Field. We're going to be in the Carenado Cessna 182 RG2, and let's go ahead and jump in the aircraft and get it started. All right, here now in the cockpit, let's go ahead and get the battery started, the alternator, and the avionics master. Let's make sure gear is down. Still clear right now. Is that a seaplane? Okay, it does have wheels. It's just clipping through the ground. That's some interesting stuff from the sim there. Let's see, everything is cold. Okay. And we're going to skip that. I'm going to let it search. We'll leave altimeter as is, and we're going to go ahead and push. And let's get the nav on. We'll leave the beacon and strobe off here for a little bit until we really want to get her started. There we go, starting the push. Take parking brake off. Bump up the range. See our full route and airspaces. I'd say that's good right about here. And put the parking brake back on. Alrighty, and let's check prop area. And we're clear. Alright, let's go ahead and get the mixture in. And let's go ahead and set the fuel pump. And about a quarter inch of throttle. And beacon strobe. And clear prop. Alrighty, started there. We've got beacon nav strobes on. Fuel pump is still on, we'll leave that on for a minute. I do want to apologize if there's any lag coming through the video here. I think this area here is just very dense with all types of foliage and stuff, so it'll be a little laggy here. We're seeming a little sensitive. I think I might just use toe brakes since it's so sensitive right now. Here in the sim, I am looking around freely, using open track with a custom built track hat. Fuel pump can come off. I just like to leave that on just for a little longer. Nearing the departure point now, we're going to do our run up, make sure that the engine's running okay. Tow brakes are in, and go ahead and set parking brake just in case. Alright, let's go. Aircraft is pulling to the right. All right, we can go ahead and lift off. trick. Maybe a little less, maybe 0.45 there. There we go. And on the wings. Okay. So here, as I just said, I'm flying the Carenado Cessna 182 RG. This aircraft does have a retractable gear, which is pretty cool to see on an aircraft of this size. I've flown this aircraft a few times before, and I haven't really had any complaints with it. I'm not a real pilot, so I'm probably doing a few things improperly, but I'm still trying my best here. I have had a few issues, not with the aircraft itself, but involving the owning the aircraft in the game. I did buy this aircraft through the marketplace, and I've had a couple times where the aircraft will completely disappear from my hangar where you view the aircraft, and it's nowhere to be found. It's not in the game files. And when it does that, it disappears from the marketplace as well, which I haven't found a solution to that. I've just had to wait for it to come back. So keep that in mind if you're planning on purchasing this aircraft. I haven't really had any issues like that with anything else. I have some improved aircraft lights and improved runway lights, and I haven't had any issues with those, given those aren't aircraft. But I plan on buying some more aircraft in the future, so I will let you guys know if I have any other issues with that. I'm just trying to be as transparent as possible, and I don't want anything bad to happen to you guys through watching me. I have not tried purchasing this aircraft through Carenado's website and seeing if that fixes it, because I feel like I've already bought it here, and I would not want the same thing to happen if I purchased it through the website and it still was happening. So, if you haven't watched the channel before, I do simulator videos such as American Truck Simulator, Euro Truck Simulator 2, and Microsoft Flight Simulator, what we're in right now. I also do publish plane spotting videos occasionally. Right now I'm attempting to post them every Tuesday at around 5 p.m. And the simulator videos, I try to go live on Saturdays at 1 p.m. And I'm not really spending a whole lot of money here. I'm just kind of in a budget. I'm just not gonna be spending a whole lot of money. I'll spend money on things that, you know, I think are worth it. Not trying to bash anything or anybody, but I like to buy things that I use on my own time outside of content creation, such as this aircraft. I've flown it multiple times outside of content creation. I just started to get back into Microsoft Flight Simulator for the channel, so that's why I'm just now flying it here on the channel. I haven't really flown any airliners yet, as I'm just not at that level. I have flown them on my own time, but I'm still very new to them, and I've really only done about two complete flights in the A320. I'm sticking more to the general aviation side of things here. I have started messing with the Citation CJ4, I believe, here in the sim, and I had a really good time with that aircraft. Just being so high up in the clouds and seeing all the earth below, it's just really breathtaking, even here in the sim. And you guys may have noticed, if you've watched a few of my Microsoft Flight Simulator videos, but I've really been flying in Virginia a lot, and I flew down to North Carolina in my last video. I haven't really flown anywhere else because I don't really know any good spots. I know mainly international airports in certain states, and I don't really know much about airports outside of the country. I'm open to trying new airports, but I'm really just flying smaller airports, as the other airports that I know of house larger aircraft or operate with those larger aircraft, such as your A320s, your 777s, your 717s, your A330s. So I'm just not really in that side of things yet, and I'm willing to branch out. I'm always open to trying something new, but for now I'm really just sticking to general aviation. And feel free to leave me suggestions below on aircraft or airports you'd like to see me fly into. And if you are a follower of the channel, you may have noticed that I didn't post a video last Saturday, and that was this video actually. But I was having some issues with my recording software, and it had just stopped recording at a point because apparently I'd run out of space, because I had it on the largest file setting, which made the video quality come out extremely well, better than honestly was needed for YouTube. You just can stop telling a difference after a certain point of quality. So I bumped it down, so I have a bit of a smaller file size, and it still is decent quality. I have not switched back to the native recorder that I was using for a while, but I've honestly been happy with the results that this one has given me. I started out using OBS, and it was good for a while. I was really liking it, but that was on my last computer, I believe, before I've gotten a few of my upgrades, and I think that it was due to a combination of my SSDs not being able to write fast enough, and just the specs of my computer, and it was just unable to write the videos all the way. And I would only get portions of video, so I swapped to a different recorder, AMD's recorder, and I was satisfied with it, other than the fact that the video quality wasn't as good. And I just wasn't a big fan of that, so I was using that for a while, and then here recently, I haven't updated my drivers. So I started having issues, or it may not even be related to my drivers, but I started having issues with the built-in recorder, and it started just crashing at random points. There was no pattern, except for, I don't even know if it was really the timing, but it would record for about 7 minutes and then crash. And it did that on, I tried to record the video 3 times, just kept crashing, so I said to heck with it, I'm gonna go back to OBS and I rolled back to an older version of OBS to before I had been having the issues with it not recording all the way. And so far, I've been pretty satisfied with it. Except the last time I went to record a video, it recorded the entire video, but my editing software would only pick up 8 seconds of it. And I don't believe that was due to the file size, because I let it buffer for about 4 hours and it still only had 8 seconds of the video. However, when I went to play it with a player, it played all 38 minutes of the video and then the other 20 minutes that I had recorded. I think it was just due to the recorder crashing because I ran out of space. So that's why I downgraded to the slightly smaller file size, as the one before was taking up to 7 gigabytes per minute, which is quite a lot. Enough about computer recording softwares and computer specs. Some upcoming videos that I have here on the channel. I've got a really exciting video that I'm really excited to share with you guys this coming Tuesday. I already have it fully edited and it's ready to go on Tuesday, so don't worry about that getting canceled. I really hate having to say that, but I always feel really sad when I'm unable to put out a video for you guys. And next Saturday, I believe, we'll be back in American Truck Simulator. Probably going to be finally trying to check out the C680 for American Truck Simulator. I know I'm really late on that bandwagon, but better late than never, I guess. Not really doing it for the views. I'm really just wanting to jump in and try it out for myself. And if you guys want to come with me on that, then that's up to you guys. And then Saturday after that, I'll be doing Euro Truck Simulator 2. I really try not to repeat videos from a certain game. I just try to jump back and forth between these three, and I may have a fourth game coming up here soon. I'm just not sure yet. I'm still looking into that more, and I've got family that's looking a little bit into that game some more, doing some research up on it. But yeah. Just trying to keep consistent on the videos for you all, as they're a lot of fun to make for me, and I hope you guys are enjoying them. And the plane spotting videos, I'm still trying to catch up. I'm in November now, so I've moved up a month, and I do have a very exciting plane spotting trip coming up here soon that has been requested, I think it's about 3 or 4 times for me to go to that airport. I don't want to spoil it too soon, but I'll probably be uploading a picture probably a few days after I went to that airport. This one will probably be coming out, I don't know. I'm not sure how many plane spotting videos I have to catch up on, but I do have more. I don't want to give away too much, but I still do have some exciting aircraft videos from Lynchburg, and then I have one coming up this Tuesday, and then I'm going to be sticking to Lynchburg here for a little while, and then I'll have one plane spotting video from out of Lynchburg coming up here probably in about 2 months, depending on how long it takes to catch up on videos. But with Liberty football season being over, that we'll be able to play catch up a little easier, since there won't be as many charters here in Lynchburg. Here in a minute, I'm gonna be letting you guys be view the outside of the aircraft, some cinematic shots of it, as I believe the outside of the aircraft is just, it's pretty important as the inside of the aircraft. It's just really pretty to look at, and I have not laid out my mixture. I should probably do that to stop burning so much fuel. You can see there on the indicator I'm at 26.4. That's used, and then I'm at 13.2 gallons per hour, and the more I lean out that mixture, you can see it drops quite substantially there, especially since we're doing full throttle almost all the way there, but we're not wanting to damage the prop, which pulling it back a little more there to stay in the green and not get into the red too much there. And you may have noticed that I'm not using ATC this video. I just decided it would be a lot easier to focus on hand flying the aircraft instead of having to deal with air traffic control and the aircraft. I don't think this will become a habit, but depending on what you guys think, I may leave it out of videos. Just let me know what you guys think. Trees down below. Having to put in a bit of rudder trim, the aircraft's been pulling a little left, rolling left a little bit. Over there looking pretty like usual. There we go, coming back up on this line. And we can go ahead and bring down the range a little bit since we're about halfway there. As you can see, this aircraft is very detailed. We've got some little scuffs there on the windshield up there, but not as many as the default aircraft, just more signs of use, like on the yoke there, and even on the, I guess we'd call that, I don't really know what you would call that, kind of the instrument panel. Let's just try to call it a dashboard, but I guess that's kind of a dashboard up there. Got some wear and tear on the rudder down there. Thankfully, no scratch marks, like someone's been trying to claw their way out of here, like some of the default aircraft. Interesting river down there. All types of twists and bends. I don't know if I'd want to take a larger boat out on that. Well, I don't think you'd really be able to, but still. I feel like it might be fun to maybe take a canoe on. Lots of little fields and trees down there. sun visors do work in this thing. Pretty nice one. Facing the sun when it's time to land. Let's go and get the approach set up here. Last time I checked, I believe it was 08. But I think I might actually just skip this and do just a visual for 08. Alright, I'm going to go ahead and let you guys see the outside of the aircraft, and I'll see you guys in about a minute. Welcome back. We're just passing the point of LOM right now. Still just about at the halfway point between Shenandoah Valley and Shepherd Field. And we've got the mountains off to our left there, just a little bit closer. Off the line a little bit, that may be why. I believe this airport is actually also used as an air base. It is home to the base of the West Virginia Air National Guard 167th Airlift Wing, located at the Eastern West Virginia Regional Airport, 4 miles south of Martinsburg, West Virginia. So yeah, we're going to be headed into West Virginia here today. Just at the eastern tip of it, and the airport was built in 1955 and it's still in use today. And it seems like they operate some C-17s out of here, which is pretty cool. looks like we're at 13,000 feet here, which is a little high. So I'm going to go ahead and start descending here for the airport, just to make sure that we're not too high. And off to our right, we should have another airport. We're still a little far away from that, so not gonna be looking at that one too hard yet. Goal here is about minus 500 feet per minute here. Just not wanting to dip the nose down too much. Almost look like ocean waves. It's like a big patch of power, like a bunch of land cleared for power lines going all the way from that little spot down there all the way up and over the mountain over there. Airport off to the right here. Let's go ahead and see if we can see that. It may be a little too high and a little too close to see it. Passing right on over there. the nose down. Still at about 12,500 feet, which is far too high for how far out we are. Cutting out the throttles a little more here to about, can't go that low. It's about 40% throttle. And there we go, that'll get us, let's do about 1,000 feet per minute there on the negative side. Coming down through 10,000 feet. Aircraft is starting to change as we're getting lower and lower. Coming down through 9,150 feet right here. And still no sign of the airport visually. That's the airport right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut left a little bit to try and get on the approach for runway 08. I know I just said that I don't have sign of the airport, but here it is. And still trying to descend at around 1,000 feet per minute. And I was mistaken before. We are now coming down through 9,000 feet. That was probably 10,000 or 11,000 feet before. just realized a mistake on the ground. I did not know that we could open the windows, so if I fly this aircraft again with you guys, then I'll be sure to open the windows. Sorry about that. Alright, starting turn here. I'm gonna be doing a bit of a loop here to descend altitude and get on runway heading. Seems like the wind is playing with us a little bit here. Airport. There we go. Looking a lot better on altitude than before when approaching. And we can see where the airport is when we complete our turn here. Be able to decrease our descent right here. And I'd say we'll probably keep it where it is for now. Probably decrease it a little more when we're a bit closer to landing. A tank, fuel, both wings, everything's in the green. Manifold will just stay where it is. RPM's good. And descent rate is, I'd say we'll stay about there, probably about 600 to 700 feet per minute. And speed, that'll go down once we throw out gear and flaps. Can actually increase the descent rate back to 1,000 just in case. Flaps down to 10 degrees, gear can come out, and landing lights on, and we'll go ahead and set the mixture to full rich, and bring the throttles back just a tiny bit, keep descending at the current rate. Turn on the final in just a second. And we've got green on the gear. just checking that again. And we can go ahead and turn right here. Tiny bit early, but we'll just do a bit of a more shallow turn. Second, and we're gonna go full flaps just to really decrease that speed because we're coming in a bit hot. That's just due to our descent rate. All right, flaps can come back up just a little bit. Let's that pitch down. Stay there for now. Looking a little high, but I think we'll be able to manage. Bit of lag here as some of the scenery loads in. Laps to 10. Looking pretty good on the center line here. Checking gears are down, flaps, full mixture, throttle can come down a little more. Throttle can stay. Missed the markers by a little bit, but still pretty soft landing. And we'll go ahead and taxi off to the right here. Going to Charlie. Here is good, and taxi light will come off. We've got the tow brakes in, parking brake can come on, windows will come open, and let's go ahead and shut her down. here now on the ground. I just want to thank you guys so much for sticking with me throughout this whole flight from Shenandoah Valley to Martinsburg. If you like this video, feel free to leave a like or comment if you want. I will have more Microsoft Flight Simulator videos coming up here soon, and stay tuned for that. And thank you again for watching.